Why do you need such a massive monitor? That's another question that I got a lot of times. And the answer to that is a demonstration, I guess. All I can do is show you the epic proportions of this TV.
Initiating.
Welcome back to my daily grind. Create yourself is what you'll find me doing every day and every night. No time to lose. One day, one step in the right direction. I'm Chris and I'm only here to show you if I can do it, you can do it too.
Welcome back to the vlog. It is Tuesday, another day, another chance to push hard. And the topic for this vlog is a review after 3 years, almost 3 years, using a 4K TV as a computer monitor. So let's get it. By the way, all product reviews, watch them all, whatever. I will link something. But before we get started, love goes out to all my subscribers. Thank you for making my life special and worth living to the max. So let me try to give back with a sweet, sweet video. Now, this is a topic that I wanted to cover for years. Literally. I think around 30 months ago, I got myself this massive 48-inch TV. It's a 4K TV, and I'm using this thing as a monitor. And I got a fair amount of weird questions regarding this system that I'm using. So let's talk about it. Now, the reason why I bought this is not my ideal solution, but it is a good solution. Previously, I was using a 19-inch monitor. Regular desktop monitor, but this was not enough. Later on, I used two monitors, this 19 inch, or was it 23? I don't even know, and a square monitor. Actually, here is a screenshot from a previous vlog, and I will also list you the vlog right here if you're interested. So freaking old, but it's one of the pros if you document your life for years, I guess, anyways. So there were basically two things that I wanted to solve with this approach. First of all, more space to work with, and also I wanted to have more distance to the monitor, because that's easier on the eyes, especially if you're like crazy as like me. I'm spending all my days, all day, every day in front of my monitor. Occasionally, I'm filming vlogs, and occasionally, I'm training. All training vlogs right here if you're interested. But other than that, I'm always in front of this screen. The first idea, the ideal solution, was a 56-inch 4K TV, because this would have allowed me to move away from the screen quite a bit. If you go close to such a huge TV, even at 4K, the screen door effect will be noticeable. I don't know if this is a VR thing to say, but you can see the pixels. You can see every single pixel, basically. But this thing is so huge, I think I calculated that I could move away from this TV 1 meter and 20 centimeters, and it would basically be the same as sitting in front of a small monitor. But this would have been a bit too expensive for me back then, so I settled with the 48 inch size. This thing is still as big as 4 of these regular 19 inch monitors that I was using, the one that I was using. You basically have 1, 2, 3, 4 monitors. But as I said, the pixel density is the same. Because of that, I'm not really able to move away a whole bunch. However, I'm able to increase the distance when I'm using programs that feature a meaningful zoom functionality, for example, Firefox or something like that. I'm mostly using 1/2 on landscape mode. Well, I'm using one side for example, Firefox, and the other side for Firefox as well, because why not? And the zoom looks pretty good on that, which enables me to, you know, go back quite a bit. That's cool. But I'm still using Windows 7, and Windows 7 has a terrible zoom. It's looking so bad, and it's like trash, and it's not working on every program and stuff like that. So for example, when I'm editing, I'm away from the screen like 90 centimeters, and I can't go further than that because I still need to see the freaking little texts and all. So it's not ideal, but it definitely gives me a whole lot more space for editing and for doing stuff on the computer. And it also allows me to increase the distance a bit. But that was a lot of talking. Oh my goodness. And now that I covered the reason why I got it, let's get to a few questions. So I think the question that I get the most is, how does this even work? I never really know how to respond to something like that, but why would it not work? Mostly every graphic card has an HDMI out. You just take an HDMI cable and insert it into your TV. There might be a few problems arising with the setup though, which is color chromatic. There is a thing that's called 422 or something like that. This is the quality of the color or something like that. Like, I will list you a very nice resource in the description. I think the website is called Artings Ratings. I use this to find a suitable TV, because there are, of course, things that you need to look out for. So let's get back to this HDMI. On old graphics card, they have an HDMI out, but they won't support the best color output, basically. Just read it if you want to know more about that. But generally speaking, it does work to a fairly good degree, actually. My graphics card is 6 years old and it's looking a-okay. It probably could look better, but I don't have a problem with the text or the pixels or something like that at all. Another question was the lag. And that is, of course, something that you need to pay close attention to, because most TVs, especially the big ones, they have a massive lag. It's called the input lag, I think. And most TVs also will have a game mode, but still on game mode, most TVs might lag. This one has a lag of around 20 milliseconds, 22, something like that. It's fairly fast. And I'm running this thing on game mode all the time, of course. But a double digit delay, basically, is definitely noticeable when it gets to gaming. So I would probably not recommend this solution for gaming. By now, there are TVs that are fairly fast when it gets to the input, but this is definitely not comparable to a gaming monitor with an input lag of 3 milliseconds or something like that. So this is for sure a drawback, but this kept me from playing too much Fortnite. I actually only played Fortnite once in my life. That's a win-win because I don't have time for gaming anyways. Playing Halo on the Xbox is no problem though, but I think like high-end game PC gaming. Anyways, and lastly, that's another question that I got a lot of times. Like, why do you need such a massive monitor? And the answer to that is a demonstration, I guess. Oh yeah, of course, the polarizer. All I can do is show you the epic proportions of this TV. As you can see, I'm using just this small of a section for the video preview because anything more than that, it would be too big. But the best thing about this, it allows me to have the effects panel right here. This section right here is my media bay or a reference monitor or like levels and stuff like that. Sometimes I'm using a mixer up here, but the best thing without a doubt is this massive timeline. There are currently 8 video tracks and probably even more audio tracks, and this made my workflow so much more efficient. It is amazing. Previously, I had the preview video on one monitor and the rest on the other one, but this is sub-ideal. Is that even a word? Suboptimal. This is just amazing in every regard. This is usually how I use my Firefox. 2 windows right here when I'm uploading and doing cards or something like that for my videos. I have the video on one side and I have the Word document or anything else on the other side. Well, when I'm doing the descriptions, I'm using Word, like whatever. It's just so freaking epic. It is so amazing. I don't even have to turn off my screen any longer. I just unpolarize it. So yeah, this was my review after 3 years of using a 4K TV as a monitor. I can for sure recommend it, especially if you're using it to accompany a workstation. This is amazing for video editing, for picture editing, like all creative efforts, or should I say endeavors. But if you're more into gaming and super fast response, then disregard this approach, I think. But I do not regret the purchase of this thing whatsoever. It enriched my life in so many ways. It would have been even better to get the bigger version, and I think the bigger version would have been like $500 more. So I kind of regret that I cheaped out a little bit back then, but could be worse, could be way, way worse. My workstation is for sure on fleek, but yeah, that's enough progress for today. Smash that like button. I need a new PC, by the way. My old one is 6 years old. Smash a like button the way I want to smash my old PC. No, actually, I love it because it's still working. That is actually amazing. Anyways, bang the bell like crap to never miss product reviews, or I don't freaking know. But yeah, that's it for today. I will see you tomorrow.